All right, it's time for the closing of Module 5. In this module, we focused on how do you build fact fluency within intensive intervention in Part 1. In Part 2, we focused on effective problem-solving strategies within intensive intervention. And then we finished up with a quick session, a section on a motivational component that's important to incorporate within intensive intervention. So let's go ahead and check in with our teacher, Mr. Flores.
A quick update. I've started DPI with my students. It's going well, and I am documenting solid growth in my students' math skills. However, I know that math fluency is essential in mathematics, and my kids seem to retrieve math facts very slowly. What are some strategies I can use to help them?
So I bet we helped Mr. Flores out quite a bit by giving different math fact fluency building strategies to embed within intensive intervention. And you shared some with your colleagues, so now you have even more strategies that you can use in your intensive intervention. So where are we? So we have done modules 1 through 4, and we are here, where instructional strategies that should be embedded within our instructional platform and also can be embedded within any intervention adaptations that we choose to do. So next, we are going to head into some math content modules that talk more about whole number content and rational number content. But what did we learn in this module? Let's do a quick review. In Part 1, we talked about students need to understand the concepts, strategies, and they need to build fluency for the big four operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. And so how do students build fact fluency within intensive intervention? You as a teacher need to teach the concepts, you need to teach the strategies, and then you need to give students lots of good fluency building activities, and that's usually a variety of activities and games. In the second part of this module, we talked about effective problem-solving instruction. So we talked about the necessity to use different attack strategies, and then we also talked about 6 schemas that we see very regularly through elementary and middle school. And those, the schemas are total, difference and change, equal groups, comparison, and ratios and proportions problems. So in Part 2's checklist, we checked off not using keywords tied to operations, but using an attack strategy, teaching students the schemas, explicitly teaching problem solving, doing the problem solving instruction regularly, and making sure that we practice the schemas that students are going to need the most. And then in Part 3 of this module, we talked about the motivational component that's meant to keep students on task and help students' attention be focused on the mathematics and to help students regulate their behavior. So how do you incorporate a motivational component? You just have to utilize one when it's necessary to do so. So we've got our instructional platform. We talked all about explicit instruction and multiple representations and our precise and concise language. But as part of that, those are all really instructional delivery components that we talked about in a previous module. So in this module, we talked about these instructional strategy components that absolutely should be embedded within intensive intervention. And why do we talk about all of these 6 things? Because they are the recommendations for good, strong instruction for students with learning difficulties. So I'll put them up here again, just so that we're reminded how important they are. But again, these are the strategies for instructional delivery, and then these are instructional strategies that should be embedded within intensive intervention. So I think you're ready to do the classroom application. The classroom application here involves identifying 3 different word problems that your students or a student might be asked to solve on an assessment. So you could look at your state assessment, you might look at a unit test, or some type of other assessment that students regularly are asked to solve. And then based on that identification of those 3 word problems, you're going to determine which attack strategy would be best for those word problems. And then I also want you to identify the schemas that then you need to provide instruction on in order for the students to be able to solve those different types of word problems. And this is all important because we need to think about providing word problem instruction within our DBI framework. And that word problem instruction should be provided here within our instructional platform. And we can also amp up the problem solving instruction within our instructional adaptations. So looking ahead from here, we have completed our first 5 modules. As I said just a little bit earlier, we're going to head into modules 6 and 7, where we talk about important components for whole number content related to intensive intervention, and then important components for rational number content within intensive intervention. And to get us ready for module 6, I'd like you to check out this article. It's about early numeracy competencies and how those are important for students with learning difficulties. So start reading that, and I will see you soon.